गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू ऑल?
फाइन सर।
वेरी गुड। ओके, लेट्स कम टू द टॉपिक टुडे, मोशन ऑन ए रफ सरफेस। मोशन ऑन ए रफ सरफेस, ऑलरेडी यू अंडरस्टूड अबाउट समथिंग अबाउट फ्रिक्शन, राइट? व्हाट इज फ्रिक्शन? फ्रिक्शन फॉर्मूला, ओके, एंड व्हाट इट अपोजिस बेसिकली फ्रिक्शन, हाउ फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स एक्ट्स, एवरीथिंग वी अंडरस्टूड। नाउ वी विल अंडरस्टैंड one object, how it is moving on a rough surface, it is moving or not moving, or when it can move, that one we'll try to understand. So give heading motion on a rough surface. Now I'll try to start the topic here. What topic here? Now we have to understand when your applied force, case one is what? When applied force is greater than maximum static friction, greater than fs max, maximum static friction, okay, this condition I'll take. So what I'm saying here, one object, it is on the floor and one mass m, actually this is a block. Now a force is acting on this capital F, and this surface is rough surface. And mu value is, suppose mu s, static friction given mu s. Okay. Now if the object is present here, then this object is moving or not? That one we'll try to understand. Object is moving or not? First, if we'll do here free body diagram of a block. If I'll do a FED of block or mass M, if I'll do FED, so what I'll see, free body diagram, now normal reaction upward direction, one mg downward direction, and in this direction F, and in this direction is FS, starting friction value. Okay, friction is acting like this. Now here condition, what we told, condition is applied force, capital F is greater than static friction maximum value. Okay, so this is, suppose I am telling it is Fs max acting here. Here what is acting? Fs max. Static friction maximum value is acting here. And what is Fs max? That one already you know. Fs max is nothing but starting friction maximum value, which is mu s times n. And here if you see n equal to mg, because vertically there is no motion, so motion will be in horizontal direction, okay, because horizontal direction, why? Because capital F is greater. If capital F is greater than Fs, then definitely acceleration will be rightward direction, so there will be no vertical motion, so n will be equal to mg here, n will be equal to mg. So n equal to mg, so that is the reason you got these things, fs max equal to mu s mg, you got this one, yes or no? Now in this case we understood that this object will move. If your capital F is greater than fs max, we understood that object will move. So here what I'll write here, star mark point I'll write, object will move, our object is moving on the surface. Your object is moving. Object is moving on the rough surface. Next, listen. Here, if you want to find acceleration of object, you want to find what is the acceleration of object, then acceleration will be A, which is nothing but F minus Fs max divided by M, F minus Fs max, because the net force in horizontal direction is F minus Fs max, So net force by mass. Acceleration is what basically? Net force by mass. Okay, try to understand. So when capital F is greater than Fs max, okay, then you can understand that your object is moving. Object is moving. If I want to ask you, what is the frictional force? What is the static friction value? What is the static friction in this case when object is moving, acceleration is there? The static friction will be nothing but it is Fs max, it will be Fx mass, or basically limiting friction, which is mu s times n, or in this case it is mu s times mg. Okay, so this is the conditions you are getting when applied force is greater than friction. Okay, frictional, maximum value of frictional force, static friction value. Okay, actually static friction, it's a very peculiar nature. We'll try to understand in the case 2. Okay, static friction things. First you understand, if you are applying, F is applied force, whatever applied force given, that is capital F. If that applied force is greater than your maximum value of static friction, okay, how to find static friction? With this formula you can find static friction. Mu s will be given in question, mass will be given, g value you know 10. So you can find here Fs max. After finding, you can check, you can compare F and Fs max. If you compare and you are getting that F is greater than Fs max, then what is happening? Motion is happening. Object is moving. Object is moving. Acceleration of object is this much. And the static friction value is how much here? Now that is Fs max. Okay, Fs max or limiting friction. Static friction value in this case. Now case 2 will see, if applied force is less than Fs max, then what is happening? Motion is happening or not? Then what is the acceleration and what is the static friction value? What is the static friction value? Okay. So understand carefully this, all the things. See, if an object is there and rough surface is there, friction value is mentioned, static friction, coefficient of static friction, and you have applied with a force, one force given to you. The object is moving or not moving, how to identify? That is what we are getting the point. Okay, here. So here, first when considering applied force is greater than Fs max, this force is given in question. Fs max you are finding from this formula. Then you are checking that if F is greater than Fs max, then object will move. Object will move towards right with acceleration A. Object will move towards right with acceleration A. That's the acceleration of object is net force. What is the net force here? Now applied force minus Fs max. Applied force minus Fs max. Okay, understand that. Okay, all of you listen. Second case. What is the second case? Case 2. Case 2, all of you know this. Here I am telling your applied force. Applied force is less than maximum value of static friction. Maximum value of static friction. Your Fx max is greater than F. This is capital F, huh? Capital F. This is your Fs max or limiting friction value you can tell. So capital F is less than Fs max. If this condition happening, we'll see what is there. All of you listen, one block is there. Okay. On the floor. So this is the mass M. One force is applied, capital F. Force is applied, capital F. Now this is your rough surface. Rough surface. Value is mu s. Value is mu s. Now what is happening here? Now free body diagram I will do here. Free body diagram. This direction is normal. This direction is mg. And here it is fs. Here force acting. Okay. What force is acting? We'll try to see. See, here this is your F. What will be the static friction here? What will be the static friction? That one will try to understand. I cannot tell here it is mu times n. That is Fs max value is mu times n. Okay. So all of you listen here. in this case, when applied force is less than frictional force value or Fs max, you calculate your Fs max, no reach. You calculate your Fs max, your Fx max is this much, mu s into n, or basically mu s mg. You calculate and you told here your F is less than Fs max. If this condition is there, then object will not move. Object will not move. If object will not move, so I'll write your Sturmer point. So what I'll write? Object is not moving. Object is not moving on the surface, on rough surface. If object is not moving on rough surface, what will be acceleration say? What will be acceleration here? Acceleration will be zero. So acceleration of object, if you write, what is the acceleration of object? Now that will be zero, because it is not moving. Here no acceleration is there. That means I told here acceleration is zero. This object is not moving at all, because F is less than Fs max. Now can you say, in this direction you are applying one force, capital F. All of you listen. One capital force you applied, but one opposite force is Fs is there, and you are telling this is not moving. That means what? That means this Fs value is nothing but it is capital F. Fs value is nothing but it is capital F. Then this capital, up capital F, down capital F, they are cancelling each other because they are opposite direction. Okay, why I am doing Fs here, Fs always here? Because Fs always parallel to the contact surface. That is the reason I am doing here. So that means what you understood here? You understood that your static friction value will adjust itself. Static friction, its value will be adjusted automatically. So that this force will cancel each other. There is no net force on this. Acceleration zero means what? No net force on this object. Already I'm telling one force applied, capital F, towards right. That means definitely this friction value is capital F. So that this capital F getting cancelled. So that means here, when your F is less than Fs, if I'll ask you what is the static friction, that means what is the value of the static friction, then what will tell? Now that is nothing but, that is applied force, that is equal to what? Applied force. That is equal to applied force. We'll take different example, we'll try to understand. Yes or no? This many things you should remember. Okay, one object will move on rough surface or will not move. It is defined by what? Applied force and Fs max. You have to check what is your applied force value, what is your Fs max value. If it is Fs max is greater, then it will not move. Or applied force is lesser than Fs max, then object will not move. Acceleration zero and static friction value equal to applied force. So what happened here? Now static friction is adjusting its value when applied force is less than maximum static friction. Okay, that means if you applied 1 newton, this value will be 1 newton static friction. It does not depend on this formula. Okay, mu s mg formula. Are you getting or not? When motion is not happening, whatever force you are giving, same force friction also giving you. Yes or no? So that's why friction is called basically self adjusting force. Static friction, what you call? Static friction basically, what you call this one? Static friction, it is self adjusting in nature. It is self adjusting. Self adjusting force. So which friction is self adjusting force? Static friction. Okay, it will adjust its value. Whatever applied value, same value it will give when applied force is less than Fs max. Okay, so it is self adjusting in nature. It is self adjusting in nature. Okay, self adjusting in nature. That also you can remember. So it's adjusting its value. Whatever applied force, same static friction coming. Okay, 1 newton you give, Fs max also 1 newton. 2 newton you give, Fs max also, sorry, Fs. Fs means static friction. Fs max means maximum value of static friction. Okay. So static friction you understood, it is self-adjusting in nature. Write down, self-adjusting in nature. Next lesson. One question lesson here. One object is there on that on the floor. On a floor, one object is there. Mass M. It's a rough surface. Rough surface. Your static friction is mu s. Mu s, you take 0.2 around, 0.2. This mass is given, mass value also given. This mass is 10 kg. And here you have applied one force, applied force, which is 2 newton. Applied force is how much? 2 newton. Now what I write here? Now write, find I, acceleration of object. Acceleration of object. Second one, static friction value. Static friction. What is the static friction here? Okay. Or value of the frictional force. What is the value of frictional force? Now see, how to approach this question? First understand. First understand what is given. One force is applied. 10 kg block is there. Mu s is 0.2, rough surface given. You have to check your applied force is greater than Fs max or less than Fs max. If applied force greater than Fs max, then this one will move, this object will move, acceleration will be non-zero. Okay. But if applied force is less than Fs max, then object will not move, acceleration will be zero. Okay, if applied force less than Fs max, now this condition, object is not moving on rough surface, acceleration of object is zero. Yes or no? So now you check here. First, what you have to check? Now to check applied force, already know what is applied force? 2 newton. Now you need to find what is your Fmax. You need to find what is your Fmax. First, you find what is Fmax. So Fs max is nothing but it is mu s times n. And n, where you have to find? Now you have to do the free body diagram. Yes or no? So do the object free body diagram, 10 kg. Now this is the normal reaction n. This is the 10g. 10g means 100 newton. So or mg, basically you can tell also 10g. 10g is nothing but it is 100. Now this way you have applied force capital F. Now I want to check here what is Fs max. So Fs max is nothing but mu s times n, and n will be 100. So now I can write here mu s is nothing but 0.2 into n value is 100. Your n value, what I wrote? N value 100, 10g, or that is basically 100 newton. So this is the normal reaction, okay? Now here what I do, 2 by 10 into 100. Now tell how much coming? 20. So Fs max is 20. My Fx max is coming 20 newton. 20 newton is coming. Yes or no? Now what I'll do here? Now my applied force is 2 newton. Applied force how much newton? 2 newton. Fs max is 20 newton. So now what condition is coming here? Everyone say. Here what is happening? Here tell. Capital F is less than Fs max. Object will move or not? So mass 10 kg is not moving. Is not moving. This condition, case 2 condition came. Is not moving on rough surface. Not moving on rough surface. If a mass M is not moving, then what is the acceleration?
Zero.
Acceleration is zero. Acceleration of object is zero. Acceleration of object is zero. Or acceleration of 10 kg. Okay, this is the object. Or basically you can write block also, Norwich. So this is the object. So acceleration of object or block, you can write sometimes a block also. Okay. So acceleration of object is basically what coming? Zero. So that means it is not moving, its acceleration zero. So that means if acceleration zero, what will be static friction value? Static friction value will be equal to same capital F. That means whatever 2 Newton applied, same 2 Newton. When object is not moving, your static friction value is applied force. But when object is moving, that time static friction is maximum friction, maximum static friction, mu s n. So now this I answer you got. Now second I, what answer? Second I? Now static friction. Static friction will be equal to applied force. Static friction equal to nothing but it is applied force. Okay. So that means Fs value is nothing but capital F, or Fs value is nothing but 2 Newton, because capital F is 2 Newton. So this is your answer. This is your answer. So always what? If this type of situation is given, you find what is Fs max. From Fs max you check. From Fs max you check with your applied force. Okay, your applied force is greater now, then object will move. If applied force is lesser than Fs max, object will not move. In this particular question, Fs applied force is lesser than Fs max. Object is not moving. When object is not moving, acceleration is zero. Object not moving, acceleration is what? Zero. Yes or no? So please remember this. Okay, lesson next. NCERT example 4.7 you check, all of you. One question will do. NCERT example 4.7. See here, they are telling one road is there. On this road, one truck is moving. See, on this truck, one block is there. One block is there, mass M. This truck is moving, okay? This is your truck. This is your block. Your block. This is your, you can tell, truck. Now, this M is lying on the floor of the truck. Okay? Now, what they're asking? Now, they're asking you find the maximum acceleration. What? Find maximum acceleration of a truck such that block should remain stationary. Block should remain stationary on truck. Okay. So this M is resting on that floor. When boss truck is moving, you tell what is the maximum. What is the maximum acceleration of this truck, and what maximum acceleration it will go, so that what will happen? Now this block will be stationary on the truck. Okay. So question is this one. This is the question. Now what will be answer for this? Now first you do the free body diagram of the block, and you try to understand there how this block is moving. All of you listen, there is definitely some rough surface between the floor of the truck and a block. You are in this contact surface, there will be some roughness will be there. Due to that roughness, one friction will be acting on the M. Yes or no? And how that friction will be acting on the M? Now, as truck wants to move with acceleration A, suppose truck is moving with acceleration what? A. Let me write it is A max. Truck wants to move with acceleration A max. Then what will happen? Now, here friction will act on M. Whatever contact surface, due to this contact surface, friction will act on the M in such a that it will try to move M with the truck. Then only there will be no relative motion, because friction opposes relative motion. Suppose mass is like this, truck will go like this, then there will be relative motion between two objects. But what I am saying now, Now this mass is not, mass is moving. If a mass is moving with the torque, then there will be no relative motion. So friction will act in such a that it will try to move this block with the torque, with the torque. So friction will act in this way. Friction will act what? In this way. Your normal reaction is N. Downward gravitational force is mg. Yes or no? Now F s equal to how much? Now write it is mu s. Suppose here any roughness is there, mu s into N or mu s into mg. Mu s into mg. So this is your static friction value. You got this one. Now see, if this torque is moving with acceleration a, this block also moving with what? Acceleration a. And here this block is moving with acceleration a. This is acceleration a. So tell me, for this block, which force is responsible for motion? For this block, which force is responsible for motion? Fs, frictional force, or Fs, static friction value, is responsible for the motion. So that means what I can write? According to Newton's second law, okay, according to Newton's second law, what I can write? According to Newton's second law, I can write total force, net force is Fs, which is mass times acceleration. Mass times acceleration. But remember, it is Fs max I am telling. As motion is happening, so maximum static friction value is this much. Now this is coming. Now this one is nothing but mu s into m into g, that is equal to m into a. Now here you check, mm cancels. So mu s g equal to a. Now a I can write what? Mu s into g. So this is your a max also, you can tell. So mu s is nothing but, anything given mu s? Mu s is given there. Check all of you. What is mu s is given? Mu s and m. Some value is given, mu s? 0.15. So here rough surface is there. Rough surface is there. For this rough surface, what is your mu s value given? 0.15. So now your acceleration, maximum acceleration will be this much. So this one you can write as 0.15 into 10. You can take that. That is how much coming? 1.5 meter per second square. That means your maximum acceleration of the truck is how much? 1.5 meter by second square. Then only this object can move with the truck. Are getting or not? You check properly. A you are getting as m is not coming into exist. Either mass of the truck or mass of the block not coming into exist. What coming here? Static friction value and g value. Okay, that one is playing here. Yes or no? The answer is how much? 1.5 meter by second square. So they are asking what? Find maximum acceleration of the truck so that block remains stationary. That means if it is moving with m max, this m should also move with that. Then to this m, who is making to move? Fs. Okay, Fs is making to move. So Fs should be equal to mass times acceleration. That's it. Okay, so acceleration this much. This one you can tell, maximum acceleration of truck. These are maximum acceleration of truck, or you can tell Amax. Tell Amax. So this is your answer. This is your answer. Clear idea? So here frictional force is helping M to move with the truck. Frictional force is helping M to move with the truck. So that is what is happening here. So if I'll do free body diagram only, I can do correctly. I can understand. And also I should have idea about Fs. What is the things and all about of Fs? So this is the free body diagram. Free body, FBD of block. FBD of block we did now, we got the point. So here force, only force. Fs is responsible for motion, so Fs equal to ma. Net force equal to mass times acceleration. Okay, my lesson. Example 4.9. What is given here, check. NCERT example. Understand here.
So here, one pulley system you have, one pulley system. Now one string is passing here, going here, string. Here one mass is there, that is 3 kg. And here one object is there, that object is 20 kg. And it has certain wheels here. Now it can move here. Now see here, 20 kg, 3 kg. I'm telling for this type of system, you try to find what is your acceleration. What is the acceleration and what is the tension in the string? So what the asking question here? Find acceleration, and tension in the string. Tension in the string also find. Listen, here if you see this object, another thing also given here. This object and this one, this cart basically, and this floor. On that, what is happening? Now here, you have this is a rough surface. Some kinetic friction is there. Coefficient of kinetic friction, which is 0.04. It is given like this. Between the surface and that wheels of the cart. Yes or no? Or trolley basically, that is. One is block, another is trolley. So kinetic friction given 0.04. Kinetic friction means when it moves, whatever friction exists between the surface and the trolley. This is the trolley basically. Trolley, this is the block. Okay. So this is what given all the question. This is your question. Find tension and find acceleration. Acceleration of block. Tension, how tension will come? Now for 3 kg block, tension will act upward direction. So here tension will be this way, here tension will be this way. Tension. This tension you have to find. And acceleration you consider object, this object going down, this object is coming this direction. So acceleration will be for this object right direction, for this block it is downward. Yes or no? You consider this. Okay. Now what we'll do? We'll find acceleration. How to find acceleration? I told you, you want to find acceleration for this type of systems now. Always you do free body diagram. And you get the equations by applying Newton's second law. So what we'll do first? Answers right here. Answer. So first we'll do free body diagram of a block. First block we'll try to do. So now see here, one block is there. How much block? 3 kg. Upward one force is acting, that is tension T. And downward one force is acting. What is that? 3g. 3 into acceleration due to gravity. And downward its motion is A. So what equation I can write here? Tell everyone. 3g. You will apply Newton's second law. Tell. Applying Newton's second law. What I can write? Now 3g minus T equal to 3 times A. So this is your equation 1. This is your equation 1. Okay. Now similarly what you do? You do the free body diagram of a trolley. Now see here, for trolley if you do free body diagram, on the trolley here mass is 20 kg. Upward is normal reaction N. Downward will be 20g. But here this direction tension. And this direction one force is acting, that is kinetic friction. Fk. What is Fk? Fk will be mu k into n. Fk will be mu k into n. That force is acting. Now object is moving in this direction with acceleration A, right direction. I consider right direction A. Okay. Now here if I want to write what is equation of motion, then what we'll do first, you write here what is Fk. Now Fk is basically mu k into n, or mu k into n is nothing but mg. Okay, that is 20 into g basically. So that means Fk I can write here 0.04 into m value is 20, g value is 10. Tell me how much will come?
It is 4/100 into 200.
So it is basically 8. Check everyone, it will come 8 Newton.
Fk is coming 8 Newton. Yes or no? Now all of you listen. For this 20 kg, your kinetic friction value is mu k into n. N value is m times g. So mg means here this 20 is m. G value is, what is that? 10. Substitute and get. Or 9.8 also you can take. Or g, like g also you can keep, no reach. You want to keep like g, you can keep like g. Or you can substitute, you substitute. G value 10 you consider. 10 consider and do. Okay. And here little, I can write Fk equal to 8 Newton. I can write like that. And here G value of suppose 10 you substitute now. This will come how much tell? 30. 30 minus t equal to what? 3a. You can give this one as equation 1. No reach. This one is equation 1. As compared to this, this one is equation 1 you can give. Now here see Fk you got. Now if you see this object. If you see this object. Can you find what is the equation of motion? Or you will apply. Applying equation of motion or Newton's second law. Newton's second law. Applying Newton's second law, what we can get here? Check. Now, see, acceleration towards right. Tension is also towards right. That means tension force is greater. Tension force is what? Greater. As compared to Fk. So that means I can write T minus Fk equal to 20A. I can write like that. Now T minus Fk is nothing but 8 equal to 20A. Like that I can write. This one I can give as equation 2. So one equation I got here, one equation I got here. So 30T minus 3A, one equation. T minus 8 equal to 20A, one equation. Now with these two equations I'll add, tension value will get cancelled and I can get something about acceleration. Yes or no? So two equations I have to add now. Two equations I have to add. So first you complete please. Free body diagram of block you do. Free body diagram of trolley you do. After that try to find what is Fk. After getting Fk, you substitute Fk value in the equation of motion. Whatever you got by applying Newton's second law. Okay. So these two equations now you have to add. T will get cancelled, you will get about A. Then A value if you substitute in any one of the equation, you will get about to tension. You will get about tension. Now next listen. These two equations you add. Add these two equations. Anyone having doubt in this? How this equation is coming? See, for this equation how we wrote? Now this block is moving downward. And 3G direction is downward. That means this downward force is greater. As it is resultant force is coming downward. That's why object is moving downward. So greater force minus smaller force. 3G minus T. That is net force. Net force equal to mass into acceleration. 3 into A. G value 10 substitute na 30. 30 minus T equal to 3A. Yes or no? This, in this way you got this equation 1. How you got equation 2? Now here you are observing that. This 20 kg block, this 20 kg trolley is going right direction. So in right direction, which force is there for trolley? Now tension force is there because string is connected. And it is a single string now. At each and every point, tension is same, T. Okay. Now you got tension in right direction, which is making motion, acceleration, it is there due to the tension. So that means whatever net force acting here, this is the opposing force when object moves, sir. Kinetic friction will try to oppose the motion. So Fk is basically in opposite direction, mu k n. Fk calculated, then the equation is T minus Fk equal to 20A. Because this object mass is 20, its acceleration is A. Both the acceleration same only, because they are connected by one single string. Connected system, same acceleration they are moving. So now what I'll do here, I'll add the equations. So now adding the equation. Adding equation 1 and 2. 1 and 2. What I am getting? Now 30 minus, tell ma. 30 minus T equal to 3A. T minus 8 equal to 20A. Now I will add this equation. Plus T minus T will get cancelled. What will happen?
plus t minus t will get cancel. Now what we are getting here? 30 minus 8 equal to 3a plus 20a. Yes or no? Now what I'll write it is? 22 equal to 23a. Now a equal to how much? 22 by 23. Or a I can write 22 by 23, or it is 0.96 around. It is meter by second square. Okay, this value calculate 22 by 23 how much?
0.96.
96. So 0.96 around coming. 96 meter by second square. Now this is the acceleration of block and a trolley. Block and trolley. Okay. This is the acceleration you are getting. 22 by 3 coming, or it is 0.96 meter by second square. Now if this acceleration value will substitute in any one of the equation, you will get about tension. So now substitute and get. If acceleration substitute any one of the equation, you will get about the tension. Right. Substituting the value of A in any one of the equation. Substitute in equation 1. So what will get? 30 minus t equal to 3 times how much it is? 0.96, 0.96. Now here write. Here direct write t equal to, from calculate here, calculate first. How much coming check? 30 minus t equal to, this one multiply and tell. How much coming? 2.88 it is coming. Now next day what will do? Tension will write. So 30 minus 2.88 equal to t. This one take this side, that one take this side. That means t is coming how much? 30 minus 2.88. So now calculate this one, how much tell? Answer. 27.1. Check, 27.1 Newton. So thus, right, thus tension in the string. Tension in the string is 27.1 Newton. 27.1 Newton. Capital N means Newton. Okay. So you substitute and get the answer. That's it. You checked this correctly, huh? How much coming? 27 point? Correct. Okay. So like this you have to calculate. Understood how much problem are there to calculate, what things are given, and how we approach this question. We did free-body diagram, we understood the equation. After solving the equation, we got A. Then A value substitute in any one of the equation, you get a tension. Okay. That's all about motion on a rough surface. I hope you understood, everyone. Yes or no? No doubt is here. This is 2.88, okay? 2.88. This is 0.96, na? 3 into 0.96 will give this much. And while doing this calculation, be careful. Tension minus t there, if that will go on that side, it will become plus t. And 2.88, this side will come, na? This will become minus. So this all you should take care properly, okay? All you should take care properly. Then only correctly you will get. Otherwise, mistakes will happen in calculation, okay? I hope you understood. No doubt. Okay, thank you all of you. If you like, subscribe to the Lakshmi Mini Tech Academy YouTube channel. All the very best.